Hello and welcome to the next video of Magento API REST tutorials. On this tutorial, I'm gonna show you how you can create a category. As you can see here, we have to make a post V1 categories, and we are going to need to submit a body in the call, and then it looks like this is what we need to send. If you click here, it will basically kind of paste it in this box. So this is what we need to submit to Magento in a JSON format so we can create categories. The only thing that is required according to this is the name, and I think the rest we can leave it blank. Obviously if you have it, it's great, but in this case I don't have it. So before we can send this, what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna copy it, and I'm going back to that website that I told you about that you can, it's like a utility that you can convert JSON to C sharp. So I'm gonna erase this, and I'm gonna call it category. I'll check this box, and I'll do JSON property, and I'll hit submit. And down here, as you can see, I have the class done for me. So let me see, this one looks like it's empty, which is fine because for this tutorial I don't need it. So I'm gonna start and create a class here. Where is this guy? I'm gonna say add a class, and I'll call it category. Like that, and I'll just copy and paste this guy. Whoop, need that one, so I'll just leave it blank. I'll just then copy it at all. Okay, so we got category and all these other ones. I got two categories. Why is that? Okay, let's see what's going on. I fixed this one, so I'll bring this one. Attributes, I don't think we need that. Let me see. I think this utility sometimes has bugs, so it doesn't match up correctly because I have category here and I have category down there. So let's see what this one was. Category on the top. Okay, let's see, custom attribute, what is it complaining? The namespace already contains custom attribute. Okay, let's check it out here, custom attribute. I guess in this demo, I'm just gonna remove this. We don't need that. We don't, probably don't even need none of that either. So I'm just gonna delete this. I don't need custom attributes. Now the class name is category, and it looks like the property we cannot name it, so that's fine. We'll just say category. I'll just say product. Like that. And this does not matter as long as you have the JSON property. This is what it's gonna serialize to into category. And this name needs to match with this. So we're gonna try it out. So it's still complaining because this one is still category. So I don't know what this utility did. What is it doing? Okay, let me find out. Okay, so I'm gonna rename this one product category, and now put this back as it was before, and now we should be fine. Okay, this is the category and this is the bucket basically that it's gonna fall into. So now what we need to do is go back, close this one, go back here, and then here we're gonna basically build the object. So we're gonna say equals a new category. Well, we're gonna say in this case product category, and then we have a category here. So equals new like that, and all we need to do, I think, is say the name. I'm not sure, so we're gonna try it out. So I'm gonna say category, I'll just say shoes. It doesn't matter what it is, but we need to see if it works. So now we're gonna assign this to category like that. Okay, we got that. Now we need to serialize this object into JSON. Okay, so I'm gonna go back, scroll up, and then you're gonna do the same thing we did when we got the token. So once we have the object created with the values, all we need to do is add this. Basically, I'm gonna copy this whole thing, and we're gonna paste it in here. Obviously, now here we have to update this to cat, and we're done. And we're not returning anything yet. So we'll break a breakpoint here and see what's going on. So let's see what happens with this. So now we'll go to the client, and now I don't need to get a SKU. Now I'm gonna call it, create another static here just to keep it clean. Create category. And all we need to do is pass in the name, at least on this example. And we'll just do copy this guy like that. But on this one, let's see, I have a token already, so I can use this one, token. What I'm gonna do is do this on, I'm gonna create a private over here. Like that. And then we have access, global access to that token down here. And we're gonna say Magento, then create category, and we're gonna say name. Just like that. And in our main, now we can say create category, and we'll say, I don't know, Domino's. And I think there's a mistake over here. So let's see this one. Here's the mistake. We'll say category name. Okay. So let's see. We're ready. Now we're going to click start. And we'll see if we have a category created. I think code 0. Okay, let me restart the app again. Okay, status code unauthorized. Okay. So that did not work. So let me troubleshoot it real quick. Okay, I think I found the bug in here. I forgot to add the token here. Token equals token. So the token was null, basically. That's why we didn't have access. So now we start again. Continue. Go. And status code. Okay. So looks like we were able to create the category. And if we see, well, let's see. Okay, as you can see, Magento gave us an ID back, 3, the parent ID, that's the name that we assigned, Domino's, and active is false, position and all that. Custom attributes, we don't have anything, I think. But anyways, you get the idea on how you can create attribute categories using the API, REST API. So let me know if these videos are helpful to you. If they're not, let me know also, because then I can stop doing this type of videos about Magento 2 APIs and C Sharp. Let me know what else you guys are looking for, and I'll do my best to create more videos on C Sharp and how to do stuff. Thank you for watching.